Hello and welcome to Mellow Labs. On today's episode, by popular opinion, I'm making my fridge smart. Brought to you by Patreon.
Let's start by having a look at what fridge manufacturers consider smart. Let's start with the most expensive LG model. The browser made my computer scream. It took a lot of processing to find out 5% discount code. Okay, so what do we have? The window thing, where you can knock on the thing and it shows you what's in the fridge. Cool. It's got the water/ice dispenser, which I can't technically 3D print and put in my fridge. We've got temperatures are a good thing. Let me write that down. What do they mean by asterisk Wi-Fi? It's like, technically it has Wi-Fi? Who the hell organizes their fridge like this? Who has 3 tubs of ice cream in the freezer? Why do they have pasta in the freezer? Why do they have nuts in the freezer? Why do they have spices in the freezer? Why are there oats in the freezer? Who owns this fridge? I might as well just go straight to YouTube, honestly. Okay, first video, let's go. Okay, so it has a tablet on the front. It's just an Android tablet. Cool. Can't wait for it to stop getting updates. Oh, there's a camera in it. Really doesn't let you see a lot of what's in it. I want to see the advertising photos for what that camera can see. This is what you think you're going to see with the built-in camera. Psych, you get this. You can just about see 2 shelves. Okay, well, let me add camera to the list of things I want to add. I love the pieces of ice just going absolutely everywhere. It's hilarious. It also has a door sensor that tells you it's been left open. That's interesting. Here's a top tip. Put it at a slight angle so that the door always closes by itself. Don't even need a sensor for that, but sure, door sensor. Maybe I'll be able to, like, tell how many times I opened the door. Right, I guess I have all the information I need. I'm gonna put a camera in there, I'm gonna put a door open sensor thing in there, and I'm gonna put some temperature sensors in. Right, I did some research and some rough planning, so I decided for the fridge door, I'm going to use 2 of these reed switches, which are basically just magnet switches. On the temperature side, I'm gonna use one of these temperature sensors. Unfortunately, I only have 1, so for now, I'm just gonna do my fridge, and we'll take care of the freezer in the future. For the camera, I decided to go with this ESP32 camera module. I wasn't sure if I'm going to use this one because, first of all, I've never used them, and I've heard very mixed reviews, so let's find out if it's any good. Apparently, it does come preloaded with firmware that I should be able to just, like, hotspot into. Unsecure network. Cool. It is connected to it. It does not have internet. That's perfectly fine. Well, that's not confidence inspiring. Guess I'm just going to try to hook it up into Home Assistant using ESP Home, and hopefully that works.
If you made it this far into the video, please consider leaving a like and subscribing to the channel for more interesting content. Also, I have a Patreon. If you have some spare change, you can get early access to my videos, as well as tons of exclusive content.
Right, so I've got it set up in Home Assistant. Here's the preview. And just watch this delay. Wait, it didn't... Okay, it's faster now. It's faster than it was. It was very slow earlier, but now it's like... It's slow, but it's, you know what, it's good enough. It's good enough for what we need. The one thing that's not good enough is the field of view. It's very narrow. So in order for it to see the entirety of my fridge, it needs to be more than a meter away. And I know some of you have the wife approval factor to worry about. I don't, my partner's awesome. This could possibly work if it was more convenient, but I don't like the way this looks. Luckily, somebody has made a 75mm wide-angle lens for this camera. So let's see how that looks. Now we can have the camera much closer, wider field of view, it can see everything. That's great. But still, camera in the way. This, too complicated, too cumbersome. So, I'm thinking I'm gonna sacrifice some field of view, I'm gonna not be able to see this part, I'm gonna focus on this part, I'm gonna put an attachment on the door that will have the camera be like somewhat here and see this part. And then when we open the door, it's gonna take a screenshot and then send that to Home Assistant to display it. I should point out, this is one of those videos where I'm working on a very rough solution to something, and then I'll work on a better version in the future when I figure out what exactly is wrong with this one. All right, we've got a plan. Let's go and do it. Right, so I printed this very crappy looking prototype that's gonna go on the door, hold the camera. So theoretically, if a camera goes there, the hole should be just the right size for the camera. So now I can mount it onto the fridge. Yes, I'm also using blue tack for that. So now we have it mounted on the fridge, and as you can see, when it's in the closed position, the camera doesn't even spy on you. It's covered. It doesn't see anything. And when you open it, it's like in that space where like nobody really like reaches. So it should be safe. And it gets a wide angle frame of what's in the thing. It can actually even see some of the door, which is more than I expected. But yeah, it works. So at this point, we will take a screenshot. I will have to add some kind of LED or something to like flash the fridge before it takes the photo, because it's kind of dark. Now that I know that this concept works, I can continue with the other stuff. I don't think I can connect all the sensors to this guy. He's pretty overloaded with the camera feed itself. So I think I'm gonna have to have a second D1 Mini just to do the temperature sensing stuff. Right, so I've got the board for the sensors programmed. So for example, temperature sensor. If I hold this for a minute, the temperature should go up. There we go. And these are the two read switches. So if I hold it up to this one, the fridge door opens. And if I hold it up to this one, the refrigerator door opens. That one, that one, that one, that one. Both open, both open. Awesome, let's go and install it. Right, it is finished. I've got the camera installed. I've got the sensors installed. So now, if you look at this, when I open the fridge, the light comes on, it takes a photo, and then when it does that, the light will go off, like so, and then we know we can close the fridge, and in the camera feed here, it will update and show me an updated image of what's in the fridge. Ain't that cool? So, there are a couple bugs that I will need to fix. For example, because of the way I mounted the switches for the doors, when I try to open just the freezer, It grabs both of them. Kind of a problem, not too difficult to fix, I think. It's not exactly the prettiest, if I may draw your attention to the absolute rat's nest that's up here, and also it's battery powered. So yeah, this is not a permanent installation, but I know the things I need to fix for a V2. So in the future, I will make a version 2, and it will be much better. So, it works. I will not be sharing the code because it is a mess of home assistant automations, helpers, and Node Red. It's just a mess. Oh, and ESP now. It's just a mess. I'm not gonna bother sharing it until I can make it like somewhat coherent. Right now it's just all over the place, but it works. I do wish I had like a timeline for the snapshots. I don't, because it overrides the snapshot every time it takes one. Kind of annoying, but that's the world we live in. So, apart from that, it's all done. Try not to replicating this until at least version 2. And if you have any ideas for other things I can add to the fridge freezer smart DIY home project thing, let me know. And I will see you in the next episode. Ow.
After all these years, I can finally confirm the light does go off.